Dear friends, welcome to another video. This is Nick from educates.tv and today we are going to learn how to use this RFID reader with Arduino in order to build a simple lock system. Without any further delay, let's get started. Today we are going to build a very interesting project. For the first time we are going to use RFID tags with Arduino. I have built a simple project which reads the unique ID of each RFID tag we place close to the reader and display it on this OLED display. If the unique ID of the tag is equal to a predefined value that is stored in Arduino's memory, then in the display we are going to see the unlocked message. If the unique ID of the card is not equal to the predefined value, the unlock message won't appear. Cool, isn't it? Each RFID tag has a small chip inside. If I place a flashlight under this RFID card, you can see the small chip and the coil that surrounds it. This chip does not have a battery in order to get power. It receives power from the reader, this device, wirelessly using this big coil. The reader can read an RFID card like this one from a distance up to 20 mm. The same chip exists in this type of RFID tags as well. Each RFID tag has a unique number that identifies it. That's the unique ID that we display on the OLED display. Except from this unique ID, each tag can store data. In this type of cards, we can store up to 1 kilobyte of data. Impressive, isn't it? We won't use this functionality today, but we will do so in a future video. Today, all we are interested in is to identify a specific card by its unique ID. The cost of the RFID reader and these two RFID cards is around $4. Let's now see how to build this project. The parts needed in order to build this project are these: an Arduino Uno, an RC522 RFID reader with some compatible tags, a monochrome OLED display, a small breadboard and some wires. The total cost of the project is around $15. You can find links for all the parts I use in the description of the video. The connection with the Arduino Uno board is very simple. At first, let's connect the power of both the reader and the display. Be careful, the RFID reader must be connected to the 3.3V output of the Arduino Uno or it will be destroyed. Since the display can also work at 3.3V, we connect the VCC from both modules to the breadboard's positive rail. This rail is then connected to the 3.3V output of the Arduino Uno. Next, we connect both grounds to the breadboard ground rail. Then we connect the ground rail of the breadboard to Arduino ground. The RFID reader module uses the SPI interface in order to communicate with Arduino. So we are going to use the hardware SPI pins of the Arduino Uno. Reset pin goes to digital pin 9. IRQ pin stays unconnected. MISO pin goes to digital pin 12. MOSI pin goes to digital pin 11. SCK pin goes to digital pin 13, and lastly SDA pin goes to digital pin 10. That's it, the RFID reader is connected. We now have to connect the OLED display with the Arduino using the I2C interface. So the SCL pin of the display goes to analog pin 5 and the SDA pin of the display to analog pin 4. If we now power up the project and place an RFID card close to the reader, we can see that the project is working fine. Now it's time to take a look at the code of the project. In order the project code to compile, we need to include some libraries. First of all, we need the MFRC522 RFID library. In order to install it, go to Sketch, Include Libraries, Manage Libraries. Search for MFRC522 and install it. We also need the Adafruit SSD 1306 library and the Adafruit GFX library for the display. Install both libraries with the same procedure. The Adafruit SSD 1306 library needs a small modification. Go to the Arduino Libraries folder, open the Adafruit SSD 1306 folder and edit the Adafruit SSD 1306.h file. Comment line 70 and uncomment line 69. Our display has a resolution of 128x64, that's what we are defining here. Now we are ready to take a quick look at the code. At first, we declare the value of the RFID tag that we want the Arduino to recognize. It is an array of integers. Next, we initialize the RFID reader and the display. After this, in the loop function, we check for a tag on the reader every 100 milliseconds. If there is a tag on the reader, we read its unique ID and we print it on the display. Next, we compare the unique ID of the tag we just read with the value that is stored in the code variable. If the values are the same, we display the unlock message, else we don't display this message. Of course, you can modify this code in order to store more than one unique ID values in order the project to recognize more RFID tags. This is just an example. As always, you can find the code of the project in a link in the description of the video. As you can see, with a very low cost, we can add an RFID reader to our projects. We can easily build a security system with a reader like this one, or build more fun projects. My main intention is to build some interactive games for kids using this RFID reader and a lot of RFID tags. In a future video, we will also try to write and read data from an RFID tag. At this point, I would love to hear your opinion about this RFID card reader. Do you plan to use it in any of your projects? Please post any comments or ideas in the comments section below. Thanks! If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel, in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build.